As you may know, Voron Design recently released its next generation of afterburner named StealthBurner. Today, I'm going to share with you my experience of printing StealthBurner with an unenclosed Industry version 2 using ABS. My Industry version 2 has been heavily molded. If you would like to know the detail, you can find them from my previous videos. My first impression is that the StealthBurner is slightly bigger than Afterburner, and it's not that easy to print without an enclosure. The most difficult one is the fan host. It is the longest part and it tends to warp easily. I printed it successfully at my third try. I'd like to share some of my experiences with you if you plan to print it using Industry version 2 without an enclosure. Firstly, try to print one part at a time because the Industry version 2 printer bed is not that good. It cannot maintain a consistent temperature across the entire bed. It performs the best at the center of the bed, so you'd better put your part at the center of the bed and print them one by one. Secondly, a lower infill reduces warpage. I printed the fan hose the longest part with an infill of 20% and it worked perfectly. I tried 3 times and the last 20% infill worked the best for me. I'd suggest you print the extruder clockwork 2 parts with an infill of 40% because they are the most important functional parts and its design makes it less likely to warp. For the rest of the parts, can reduce the infill to 20% or 30%. Well, StealthBurner looks great. I like the clockwork 2 extruder the best. I can see they're improving it with a lot of small details, aiming to be a more reliable extruder. However, I don't plan to upgrade to StealthBurner for now, not only because it's still in a beta version, but also there's something I'm not big fan of. The new fan host does look awesome, but to me it is a little bit over-engineering. For example, I don't really need to put LEDs into the printhead. Yes, with LEDs it might help people who record time-lapse video overnight, but it requires more wiring and uses more energy. It brings nothing to improve the print quality. The other small issue is that the fitting of the parts in Clockwork 2 is also not perfect enough. I have to work very hard to put them together. It should be an easy fix with adding an extra offset between parts. I think Voron Design can resolve it quickly in later releases. This issue might just have happened on my printer only. Let me know if you face the same issues as well. Anyway, thank Voron Design for bringing this awesome printhead to us. Keep up the great work. I really appreciate it. Alright, that's today's quick video. Thanks for watching. Stay safe and see you next one.